almost 15 years have passed since the launch of the first iPhone, so it deserves a retrospective of all the models launched so far. In 2007, at the Macworld conference, a revolutionary phone in the mobile phone industry was announced.
A widescreen iPod with touch controls, a revolutionary mobile phone, and a breakthrough internet communications device.
The phone had a 2-megapixel main camera and a 3.5-inch diagonal multi-touch screen, 158 megabytes of RAM, and a 4, 8, or 16 gigabyte storage. For all that, people had to pay $499, a very high price for a phone at the time. However, the iPhone sold over 6.1 million pieces.
We're gonna take it to the next level, and today we're introducing the iPhone 3G.
To highlight 3G technology, Apple has named the next phone the iPhone 3G. Steve Jobs took to the stage again at Apple's Worldwide Developers Conference in 2008 and introduced the new iPhone with the slogan, "Twice as fast at half the price." iPhone 3G kept the same screen size as the original, but had a new glossy plastic design. This was the first iPhone with GPS and App Store and was only available in 8GB and 16GB storage. Twice as fast as its predecessor. This is how the iPhone 3GS was promoted in 2009. It had a glass screen, voice control function, a bigger battery, and was also available with the 32GB storage option. The camera has been upgraded to 3 megapixels, has autofocus and video recording. iPhone 3GSs were very successful, with over 1 million units sold in the first weekend of launch. The iPhone 4 was a major redesign, coming with a glass construction with straight metal edges. It was the first iPhone to come with a Retina display and a new 640 by 960 pixel resolution. It was also the first iPhone with a front camera. It had a 5-megapixel main camera capable of recording video at 720p. And this model was very successful with about 50 million units sold. 2011 was probably the saddest year for both Apple and its fans. On October 5, just one day after the introduction of the iPhone 4S, Steve Jobs died. At the helm of Apple is Tim Cook, who supported the presentation of the iPhone 4S. The iPhone 4S comes with the same design as its predecessor, the major difference being the camera that went from 5 megapixels to 8 megapixels. The iPhone 4S came with a more powerful dual-core chip, the Apple A5, and a 64GB storage version was available. It seems that this model has become more popular than its predecessor, with approximately 60 million units sold. The iPhone 5 came with a revamped design, but not by much. It was the thinnest iPhone ever, it was bigger, the screen size increased from 3.5 inches to 4 inches, and the aspect ratio was 16 by 9. The iPhone 5 also came with a faster A6 chip, 1GB of memory, improved front camera, LTE connectivity, and the Lightning connector was introduced. In the first weekend since its launch, the iPhone 5 has sold over 5 million pieces. An update to the iPhone 5 was released in 2013, namely the iPhone 5S. It came with a new chip, the Apple A7 Cyclone, the first 64-bit chip on a phone, and introduced Touch ID, dual flash and slow motion video, and improved battery life. The iPhone 5S was amongst the most popular iPhones, selling over 160 million units. At the same time, the iPhone 5C was launched with a price tag $100 cheaper than the iPhone 5S. It was made of plastic and was available in several colors. Larger screens and rounded shape, these were the main changes brought to the iPhone 6 and 6 Plus. Apple has introduced 4.7 and 5.5-inch Retina HD screens respectively, a 128GB storage option, and optical stabilization on the Plus model. The iPhone 6 models broke sales records with approximately 222 million units sold. Of course, Apple has launched the S models for iPhone 6 and 6 Plus. They look the same as the previous ones, the changes being inside. First of all, the camera went from 8 megapixels to 12 megapixel, and the RAM was doubled. At the same time, the phones had an A9 chip, which was 80% faster than the previous one. They were also the first iPhones capable of recording 4K video and came with live photos. Apple has launched a more affordable $399 phone. iPhone SE from 2016 is similar in shape to an iPhone 5, but inside it has the specifications of an iPhone 6S. With the launch of the iPhone 7, Apple gave up the basic 16GB model. The new model, starting from 32GB storage up to 256GB. iPhone 7 Plus was more popular than iPhone 7 thanks to the dual camera, which made possible an improved zoom function and the application of a new portrait mode effect for users to capture a greater depth of field. The Plus also came with a larger battery and more RAM. Apple has also given up the headphone jack, bringing the new wireless AirPods headphones to market. The iPhone 7 was launched for $649 and the iPhone 7 Plus for $769. iPhone 8 and iPhone 8 Plus were launched in 2017 and used Apple's Bionic A11 chip, 30% faster than the previous one. Both models introduced wireless charging with a glass cover on the back. The camera had improved image editing and filtering capabilities, and the True Tone display automatically reduced exposure to blue light. The Plus model had a dual camera, more RAM, and a larger battery. So, if you wanted the Plus model, you had to pay $100 more. To celebrate 10 years since the first iPhone, Apple launched the iPhone X in 2017, being the first iPhone to cost $1,000. It included an additional front camera that allowed amazing photos to be taken in portrait mode. It was also the first iPhone with a 5.8-inch bezel-less edge-to-edge screen and the first with an OLED display. At the end of 2018, Apple launched three new iPhones, iPhone XS, iPhone XS Max, and iPhone XR. iPhone XS and iPhone XS Max were similar to iPhone X, priced at $999 and $1,099 respectively. New to these models was the A12 Bionic processor, 15% faster than the iPhone X. The 5.8-inch and 6.5-inch screens were edge-to-edge respectively, and everything looked great with the Super Retina HD display, and the Max model came with a bigger battery. The iPhone XR was introduced as a more affordable option and was available in different colors. It had a 6.1-inch screen and a Liquid Retina HD display. The iPhone XR has been available in 64GB, 128GB, and 256GB models, starting at $749. In 2019, Apple launched three new iPhones, iPhone 11, iPhone 11 Pro, and iPhone 11 Pro Max. The iPhone 11 was available in six different colors and came at a much more affordable price, starting at $699. The phone came with a 6.1-inch Liquid Retina display, two 12-megapixel rear cameras that offered wide and ultra-wide lenses, and a 12-megapixel front camera. iPhone 11 Pro comes with a 5.8-inch Super Retina XDR screen, and the camera comes with an upgrade, three 12-megapixel HDR lenses. You could buy this one for $999, and for an extra $100, you could buy an iPhone 11 Pro Max, which had a bigger screen. In 2020, Apple launched the second-generation iPhone SE. At the price of $400 and powered by the Apple A13, the iPhone SE was a good option. It came with a 4.7-inch screen, advanced camera system with portrait and depth control mode, high-definition video, wireless charging capability, but with a fairly small battery. With a complete refresh, Apple launched four Series 12 iPhones in 2020. Flat sides, thin body, ceramic frame, and glass back make the 12 series very attractive. All four models come with 5G connectivity, OLED displays, and the A15 Bionic chip. The main model in the series is the iPhone 12, equipped with a 6.1-inch OLED screen and is available in six colors. The phone has two cameras on the back that can make 4K videos, a front camera with a 12-megapixel sensor and 4GB of RAM. In addition, every iPhone 12 series phone comes with MagSafe, a wireless charging accessory. The iPhone 12 was launched for $799. The novelty factor of this series is the mini version. This is the cheapest phone in the range, but powerful. The model comes with the same camera specifications with the same storage and processor capabilities as the iPhone 12, only it has a smaller 5.4-inch screen and is $100 cheaper.
iPhone 12 and iPhone 12 mini are absolutely amazing. They are the start of a new era for iPhone. Yet that's just half of our iPhone story today. We want to take it even further with our Pro line of iPhones. And here they are.
The Pro variant is an advanced phone with the same size and the same basic processor as the standard iPhone 12, but it comes with improvements to the rear camera and more RAM. The iPhone 12 Pro has a 3-camera suite instead of 2 with an additional 12-megapixel telephoto lens. It also comes with more storage, with options from 128 and 256 gigabytes to the impressive 512 gigabytes. For all these benefits, the cost is worth $999. The most powerful device in this range is the iPhone 12 Pro Max. It comes with all the advantages of the Pro, but it also has a 6.7-inch OLED screen, a resolution of 2778 by 1284 pixels, and a larger battery. It is also the most expensive iPhone in the series, $1,099. In 2021, Apple launched the 13 series of iPhones, which retained the design features of the iPhone 12 series and followed the same versions: a 5.4-inch mini model, two 6.1-inch iPhones, and a Model Pro Max 6.7-inch. The biggest improvement is the battery, with differences ranging from a 10% increase in the mini model to an increase of almost 20% in the battery capacity of the Pro Max. The 13 series also brought brighter screens, a 20% smaller notch, and the fastest chips, the A15 Bionic. New photo styles and cinematic modes have been introduced, and the iPhone 13 and iPhone 13 mini borrow the camera from the 12, being a dual setup with diagonally placed sensors. This time, we have configurations that start from 128GB and reach 256GB respectively, 512GB. The Pro and Pro Max models come with much larger batteries, a larger screen for the Max model, and 3 new improved and low-light cameras. We also have a 1TB storage configuration available for the first time. The price for iPhone 13 Pro is $999 and for Pro Max, $1,099. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and share this video. See you in the next video.